alongside my brothers and my sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front lines, sleep in peace tonight. American soldier.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to sunny Southern California. We are deep into the Christmas holiday season, Hanukkah, all those good holidays. It's the holiday season, and I want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, and a wonderful New Year. You probably haven't seen me do a blog here in several weeks, and there's a reason for that, and it's all around me. It's called a kitchen remodel. This is brand new granite. It was incredibly heavy, very dense, like my skull, and it took a lot of work to actually cut this stuff into pieces so that it would fit in here. With that said, I'm back. The kitchen's functional again. Thank you for your patience. These are my planks, and this is my book. This is the 11,000 year history of barbecue.
It's called your barbecue.
New England military style burger. It is so good, it is so big, it is explosive. It is the tank burger. The tank burger was developed in 51. We developed it knowing that it would be incredibly volatile. We knew that if we put it together correctly, we could make something so tender, moist, and incredibly flavorful that it would explode your brain into a flavor coma. Let's get busy. This is a pound of chicken. Now, it's ground chicken, and you can use regular beef, you can use Angus beef, but my motto, my mantra is all about lean, versatile, and tasty. So once a week I'll have a steak, but the rest of the week I try to be lean, versatile, and tasty. So we put that pound right in there. Now, what do we put inside with it? That's a great question. And I'm about to tell you.
All right, so
first thing that we do, then we put in about a half a cup of chives. Green onions or chives, doesn't matter, whatever you like. And then basically 1 cup of a little bit of white cheese. That's all I got in there. Put all three of these items into the tank burgers. This is a military style burger, so it will have flavor shrapnel all over the place. Now, you have to be careful about that flavor shrapnel. You don't want to get cut. You don't want to hurt yourself or anyone else. There's two. There's three. Now, what goes on top of these at the end when we're finished grilling them is then we put a piece of pepper jack cheese on top of it. This is a really, really explosively military style burger known as a tank burger. It is fantastic.
We're going to stick these in the freezer for the next 15
because
minutes.
Chicken has a tendency to fall apart. Incredible little wine from Spain from, it's called Abanque. And I tried it earlier. It's basically a Tempranillo with 70% Tempranillo and 30% of Merlot. It's aged in French oak cask for over 12 months. That's a long time. And let's see here. Boy, the legs are just long and lean and beautiful, like I like my legs. Bouquet out of this world, just infusing a military style attack on drinking this. That's really nice. And I'll tell you, you can get this at Trader Joe's. This is where I picked it up this week. I believe this is $5.99 or $6.99, but for the price, you cannot beat it. It really is stepping it up a notch in that sub $10 price range. Really nice. Abancay, I think it's pronounced Abanque. You need to try it. This one is a 2009. We will be grill side momentarily. Marinate off.
Beside my brothers and my sisters, I will proudly take a stand when liberty. jeopardy. I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front line, so sleep in peace tonight.